Let us continue where we left in the previous video and discuss the comparison between Steele and Edison. Steele never permitted himself moral reflections of the kind which Edison was very fond of. The essay on Westminster Abbey could not have been written by Steele. But Edison's moral reflections were often superficial. Nothing but the grace of the style prevents us from stigmatizing the Abbey meditations as stale and trite. Edison's humor is elegant and refined. His satire, subtle and effective. Moreover, some of Steele's sentences are apt to be clumsy, but Edison rarely allowed any writing of his to suffer from crudity or awkwardness. The very character of the two friends, who together did so much as collaborators in the field of English essays, differed widely from each other. And in some respects, this very fact seems to be responsible for such a wide contrast. Steele was what is called bohemian, easygoing, most careless about money, friendly and very generous and sympathetic. He enjoyed life and the pleasures it offered with an ease and carefree feeling. Edison, on the other hand, was a cultured and civilized and urbane gentleman, dignified and reserved by nature. He was naturally refined and had lofty ideas of morality and piety. Steele and Edison together produced the remarkable essays of The Spectator. They complemented each other's qualities as writers. Steele was the more original and inventive of the two. He was more natural and easy and spontaneous in his expression. Edison gave to originality and spontaneity of Steele, refinement, polish and correctness of writing. Steele exhibited a romantic strain of writing which came out of his warm involvement in life around him. As Huff Walker remarks, quote, "The heart is dominant in Steele, whereas Edison's head dominated his character and writing," unquote. Steele writes, as a rule, less from the head than from the heart, to the warmth of which organ his rapid pen gives eager and emphatic expression. His humor is delightfully kind and genial. His sympathy is quick and springing and compassionate. His instincts uniformly on the side of what is generous, honest, manly, and of good report." Unquote. This is a quotation by Dobson. In Edison, there is a languid refinement and polish and elegance which is missing in the writings of Steele. Edison's writings lacks the warmth of Steele's approach. Edison's approach is that of a man whose head dominates over his heart, as I pointed out. And you can exemplify these theoretical sentences or these theories about their art of essay writing with apt quotations from the text prescribed in your syllabus. Steele is organized and creative, but in his creativity, there was also carelessness which checked him from being artistically consistent. In the characterization of Sir Roger, he seems to have introduced a kind of discrepancy. He paints Sir Roger as having been a dandy and gentleman about town. This seems slightly incongruous to the image of the knight as a whole. The warmth and tenderness of Steele versus the cold intellectuality of Edison is never more evident than in their humor. Steele's humor is warm and verges onto the side of sentiments of the times. Edison's is mildly astringent and frequently ironical. Steele laughs heartily and affectionately without the suspicion of a sneer. Edison would not be so freely amused. He would control, polish and refine the sentiment and express it in a precise, clear terms, candid terms. Edison was a more reasoned and deliberate critic, whereas Steele's criticism was more instinctive in nature. As far as artistic finish is concerned, there is no doubt that Edison was superior to Steele. As a writer, Edison was less faulty than Steele. Huff Walker says, again I quote, "No doubt, Edison is one of the whole superior. He is far more finished a writer more correct, more scholarly, more subtly humorous. Steele's style is like his life, as Thackeray says, full of faults and careless blunders, and redeemed like that by his sweet and compassionate nature. Unquote. There is such a thing as tone in writing as well as a style, and Steele at his best is as much superior to Edison in the former quality as he is inferior in the latter. Comparing the two writers, H.P. Ruth remarks, "It may be said that Steele was the more original and Edison the more effective. Steele conceived the periodical essay but never perfected it. Edison, without any deep fund of ideas or sympathy, raised Steele's conception of an essay to a degree of perfection never since surpassed." Unquote. E. Elbert remarks in this context that Steele is at best Edison's equal in originality and versatility. He says, quote, "His humor is broader and less restrained than Edison's. His pathos is more attractive and more human, but he is incapable of irony. He lacks penetration and power, and much of his moralizing is cheap and obvious. He lacks Edison's care and smoothly polite, ironic insight. He is heedless, inconscious in style, and inconsequent in method. And so, in the final estimate, as the greater artist, he fades. But one has to admit that Steele's writing has maintained a certain quality of freshness and charm which is lacking in Edison's." Sainsbury remarks in connection with Steele and Edison as collaborators thus, quote, "We might allow Steele a finer, certainly a more generous and heartfelt sentiment, a freer spirit, and perhaps a more creative fancy, while reserving for Edison a more generally critical temperament, a better regulated, if less chaotic taste, and certainly more mastery of that wonderful middle style to which Dr. Johnson refers. Edison and Steele were admirably suited as co-craftsmen, for each could give what the other lacked. Steele brought to his work a wide experience of life, generous sympathies, and a sunny humor. Edison brought a wide experience of literature, a polished style, and a pleasant tinge of acidity in his humor. Both were moralists at heart, with much the same outlook on the society of their day, yet there were sufficient differences in the temperament and in the gifts to be of real service in giving breadth and diversity to the work they accomplished. Whereas one is, that is, Steele is more sentimental, Edison is more of a rationalist." Thank you very much.